allow the choir to come in. I think the choir, would you please come up here on the stage, and for the laying on of hands, surround the stage area and the wall there. And I believe once the choir is in, we have everybody. And we did not anticipate quite the number of people here today as we have. And somebody just pointed out to me that's a good problem to have. And so we're thankful. We praise God for that. Thank you all for coming and creating such a wonderful problem. May God bless you for it.
Why are you rubbing?
When the Jews built the tabernacle, and later the first and second temples, they set aside a time to declare their purpose and dedicate them to the worship of their Almighty God. That's exactly what we are doing today. They gathered for praise and worship. They said prayers, read scriptures, and recommitted themselves to serving and honoring their Lord. This scripture reading describes Solomon's dedication of the first temple.
Where's the demon coming out at?
A reading from the first book of Kings, chapter 9, starting with the first verse. The Lord appears to Solomon. As soon as Solomon had finished building the house of the Lord, in the king's house, and all that Solomon desired to build, the Lord appeared to Solomon a second time, as he had appeared to him at Gibeon. And the Lord said to him, I have heard your prayer and your plea, which you have made before me. I have consecrated this house that you have built by putting my name there forever. My eyes and my heart will be there for all time. And as for you, if you walk before me as David your father walked, with integrity of heart and uprightness, doing according to all that I have commanded you, and keeping my statutes and my rules, then I will establish your royal throne over Israel forever, as I promised David your father, saying, you shall not lack a man on the throne of Israel. But if you turn aside from following me, you or your children, and do not keep my commandments and my statutes that I have set before you, but go and serve other gods and worship them, then I will cut off Israel from the land that I have given them, and the house that I have consecrated for my name I will cast out of my sight, and Israel will become a proverb and a byword among all peoples. And this house will become a heap of ruins. Everyone passing by it will be astonished and will hiss, and they will say, why has the Lord done this to this land and to this house? Then they will say, because they abandoned the Lord their God, who brought their fathers out of the land of Egypt and laid hold on other gods and worshipped them and served them. Therefore, the Lord has brought all this disaster on them. May we here at Winston always worship God alone in the way prescribed in his eternal word. And may his name be forever honored in this place until Jesus comes again.
Today's dedication service has a twofold focus. The obvious one being the dedication of this building to God, and we are committing to use it in accordance with His holy word, the Bible. And in just a minute, I'm going to invite you to place your hand on the exterior wall, or if you can't reach the wall, on somebody's shoulder between you and the wall, as a way of sort of laying hands on this place. If you're seated, I'll invite you to reach down and touch the floor, or if you can't reach the wall, touch some aspect of the building, as we'll be praying to dedicate that sort of laying on of hands. But I also want you to consider dedicating or rededicating yourself to the Lord as well. Maybe it is that you have wandered from the Lord to some degree, or maybe you haven't been following Him as closely as you know you ought to be. Then again, maybe you have been serving and following the Lord, but there's room for improvement. In order to renew and refocus your life. When we pray, I'm going to invite you to place your other hand across your heart. A sort of dedicating of yourself to God today. Sort of laying hands on yourself and committing to continually re-examine and rearrange your life in accord with His will. With one hand on the wall and the other hand on your heart, then the prayer will dedicate both this place and this people to the Lord. Will you bow your heads and pray with me? Father, as we think about this new building, we know there are many aspects of ministry that will take place in many different areas. And Lord, we dedicate the nursery for the youngest members in our midst. We ask your blessing. Watch over them, protect them, equip them and us as parents, mentors, and guardians to be the people they need to grow them into the people the world needs. Because as the world desperately tries to lead them astray, we will do all we can to keep them on the straight and narrow, your path. Father, we pray a dedication on the beginner's room as the children grow. Help us to nurture their budding faith. Equip the volunteers who work with them. Father, for the mission room, we dedicate that. It is dedicated to the study of your word in order to take the gospel to the very ends of the earth. Reveal yourself in powerful ways so we can continue to support the global mission of the universal church. Father, we dedicate the vestibule as we gather together, meeting old friends and making new ones. Bless our gathering space and the laughter and the stories that will be shared in it. Father, we dedicate even the service areas for the areas that support the ministry here, the mechanical rooms, janitorial closets, AV room, and storage areas. We know that even in your temple there were such areas, and they were used and essential to the effective use of the whole space. So to effectively worship, we need these places as well. To effectively provide your ministry, we need these spaces, and so we dedicate them to you. Father, we dedicate the kitchen to you, for the kitchen from which food and coffee will be served, we give you thanks in advance. We know that a big part of building community is breaking bread and sharing meals. You have designed us that way, and so we look forward to the meals that we will share, the first of which is today. We give you thanks for the service that will take place in the kitchen, and we dedicate it and the meals to come to your glory. We give you thanks for this hall, where we will meet and eat those meals, this Memorial Fellowship Hall. We praise you for all the saints who have contributed to making it possible, some of whom are with us today and some of whom are in your presence singing your glory. We pray your blessing on the meals that will take place here in this very room and the special events and the worship services as well. Those worship services will be sung to the music played on the new organ that you, in your gracious provision, have brought to us at just the right moment, and so we dedicate that to you as well. You made it available just as this ministry facility was being completed, and we ask your blessing on it. May the hymns, praise music, special music, and all the worship that it will be supported and empowered by this beautiful organ give you great joy and bless your heart as the people gathered here raise their voices to praise your glorious name. Father, we dedicate this place to you in its entirety. Every 2x4, every nail, every screw, every concrete block and sheet of drywall is yours. And we promise to do our best to use it to accomplish your will. May it be a place where you are regularly sought and found. A place where your word is faithfully taught. Where people find reconciliation and hope through a living relationship with Jesus Christ. May this be a place that supports your mission and promotes your ministry and embodies the love of your Son, Jesus Christ. And Father, last of all, but certainly not least of all, we also commit ourselves to you, to your ministry, to your mission, and our relationship with you. We promise to worship you regularly and zealously. For it is only with that strong tie to you that we can have the courage and the God-given wisdom to live out the faith into which you have called us. A dedicated building without a dedicated people will never accomplish your mission here on earth. And so we dedicate this place to you, and we dedicate ourselves to you, to your service, to your glory. And in your name, we pray all this, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. And all God's people said,
Amen. Amen.
In just a moment, Kathleen and Mary are going to play a musical interlude, and I will invite you to find your seats. All the hymns will be projected on the overhead without the score, so if you prefer reading music, there are hymnals located on the bookshelves by the windows, and you can grab one of those as you take your seat. There are some armchairs here in the center for people who have trouble getting up at the end of the service, so please help and direct the people who need them to those chairs. And one final thing, I urge you, choose your seat carefully, because you never know, that may be your seat for the next 20 years. You know how it goes.